web scraping. It's using software to go through and instead of manually putting everything into the Excel, you build a program to do it, it's much more efficient. So my project, I also looked at IMDb, and it's just a proof of concept to see if I could do this. And if so, you know, when could I do it in the future? What limitations are there? What's it capable of? And also, I can learn a little bit about it. So here's a look at the process. First part is just clearing out your libraries and such. I'll show you that. This is the part two, is the actual search page, and I'll go into the code for that next. And then we'll look at the actual TT movie pages that I scraped, and then finally the output. So this code here goes along, let me go back, with this search page. You notice up there on the right, that's the only thing that's different in every one of these search pages is changing the year and changing the start number of the record, whether it be 1, 50, 100. So the top part here, I have, you can change the start year and end year, and then also how many per year. So I did 50 years and 100 per year for 5,000 movies. So the first part, after I cleared it up, and move on to the second part, is actually scraping the list of URLs that I would then scrape all the data from. So I put some for loops here and some generic code. And then the key is down here where I use a beautiful suit to identify a certain area in the HTML markup where all the TT numbers are, which is what I need to make the URLs. And all I do at the bottom is pull those out and then snip the strings in the front and the back, and it leaves just that. Once I have those 5,000 TT numbers, which I can use to generate these URLs, because you can see in there the TT number, that's the only thing that's different. I went through and one by one went through these data points. I have 12 on here, the red stars, there's four along the bottom that you can make it on this page. And for each one of those, I just went ahead and wrote the code. This is the simple code down here, and then some of them were much more complicated. It's just a case of identifying where the HTML is, turning that into a string, and cutting the front and back off the string. This is some of the more complex code when you have some issues, when everything just doesn't line up one-to-one. For example, up here, I had analogical tests because not everything has a content rating. Some movies are unrated. I also had some movies with two genres, some with one, some with three. So I included two, so I had to go ahead and only had one genre, and marks the second one as empty. At the end of this iteration, for whatever page, in this case it was The Dark Knight that I was looking at first, when that iteration is done, all the data is stored in this TT details list, which I just append to another list, the list of lists, the movies list. So until I write to the CSV, everything's sitting there in a list, which is a Python object. Then here at the bottom, it's only three lines actually exported to the CSV. So here's the output. Obviously, I just chopped it off at the first 20 or so records. It did 5,000 movie pages. So in summary, web scraping, it's all you need is introductory knowledge, or less than 2%.